Wind chimes have been a standard addition to a garden space, dating all the way back to ancient Rome, India, and China. These early chimes were made by hanging small bells so that a slight breeze would create a tinkling sound. Creating something that looks like a wind chime is easy, but there are other considerations than aesthetics at play. Modern chimes must sound pleasant as well. This is achieved by using a material that will reverberate when struck. With a little bit of sculpture wire, canvas, and plaster, it's easy to create a masterful chime that sounds as beautiful as it looks. Students will even learn to play with balance and counterbalance to create a kinetic sculpture. You won't believe your eyes or ears. I have found this simple leaf shape works especially well. However, students can be encouraged to try a variety of shapes and natural motifs, such as this flower chime. No two chimes will sound alike, so it's a good idea to make a few pieces and experiment. I'm going to make a leaf chime, and the templates I'm using here can be printed from page 3 of the lesson plan PDF, available at dickblick.com. To make multiple leaves, I'm using a strip of canvas that I've folded over. Place the leaf on top and trace. And now I'm using a 12-ounce canvas, which is pretty thick. So you don't want to stack too many pieces. Once it's traced, simply cut. Cut as many shapes and sizes as needed to hang from the macrame hoop. I'm using a 6-inch diameter macrame hoop, so I'll need approximately 6 leaves. Cut a piece of armature wire appropriately sized to the leaf. You want about 1 inch in excess. Armature wire comes in a variety of sizes or gauges. I'm using the 14-gauge wire. It's just thick enough to produce the appearance of a veining in the leaf without being too thick or heavy. Next, fold the leaf in half and make small cuts along the folded side about 1 inch apart. Open up the leaf and begin to weave the wire through. You can begin at either end. Repeat this for all the leaves. Bend the wire to mimic the natural shape of a leaf. The canvas may not want to follow the bends of the wire at first. We're going to use plaster strips to hold it in place. To activate the plaster, dip it in water and gently rub between your fingers. Place over the wire and the cut opening. This is essentially acting as a tape and will hold the wire in place when it dries. Place the leaves on a plastic drop cloth or brown paper, piece of newsprint or scrap paper to dry. Now, the plaster cloth will set very quickly, in about 10 minutes or so. So I'm going to start mixing the plaster. I'm using Densite plaster as it dries super hard and really makes the best tinkling noise. Share one bowl between two students and mix in batches to cut down on waste. Using cold water will help slow down how quickly the plaster sets, but even then, there is a brief window of working time. Slowly add the water, gently stir it. Generally, plaster should be the consistency of heavy cream, but we will be dipping our leaves in the plaster. I want it a little bit thinner. Mix until all the lumps and bumps have disappeared. Holding the leaf from the long bit of wire at the end, dip it into the plaster. Gently shake off any excess. Smooth over areas of canvas that still show through. You may need to dip your leaf a second time. Hanging the plaster leaves from a clothesline positioned over a drop cloth or newsprint is really the best method for drying them so they can drip down. I'm going to put mine on this bowl here. Hanging the leaves allows for a more natural shape from all viewpoints when it's hung. When all of the leaves are dry, they can be painted with watercolor. Be sure not to overload too much color, as this will dull the sound of the tinkling chime. You can also add other materials, such as brusho crystals or pastels, to add detail or other points of interest. Once the paint is dry, use pliers to snip off any excess and make a loop. Attach the thin brass wire to the loop simply by twisting. Position each piece on the macrame hoop. Twist the wire tightly a few times around the hoop. Every now and then, it's a good idea to double check your wire length and the positioning of your leaves by lifting the piece. When completely satisfied with the arrangement of leaves, place a small drop of Allene's Clear Gel Tacky Glue at the connection point to the ring. Add a piece of wire centered from one side to the other to hang. I would also like to encourage you to use found materials. Thank you so much for joining, and I hope you too can chime in with nature. For a full list of materials and a downloadable, printable PDF version of this lesson plan, including national standards and leaf template, visit dickblick.com. And while you're there, you'll also find hundreds of other free lessons and project ideas.